Welcome to an example on how to solve a system of two linear equations with two unknowns using a matrix equation. Let's review how we're going to set this up. First, our linear equations must be in standard form, meaning the x and y terms are on the left and the constants are on the right. Once we have the two equations in this form, we're going to form three matrices, matrix A, where the elements will be the coefficients of x and y. Matrix X will be the variable matrix containing the variables x and y. And matrix B will be the constant matrix containing the constants of the two equations. So once we have the three matrices, the matrix equation will be A times X equals B. And once we have our matrix equation, we want to solve this equation for matrix X. To do this, we're going to find the inverse of matrix A and multiply both sides of the equation by A inverse. And the order of multiplication does matter. It does have to be A inverse times A on the left and A inverse times B on the right. Now looking at the left side of the equation, we should recognize that A inverse times A would be equal to the identity matrix and the identity matrix times matrix X, which is B matrix X. So looking at the right side of the equation, A inverse times B will actually give us the solution to our system. So going back to our example, the first thing we should recognize is that the first equation is not in standard form. We need the x term to be on the left side, so we'll add 2x to both sides of the equation. So the first equation would be 2x plus y equals 1. The second equation is already in standard form. This is already set up for us. This first matrix will be matrix A. The second matrix will be matrix X. And the third matrix on the right will be matrix B. Matrix A comes from the coefficients of the X and Y terms. So the first row would be 2, 1. The second row would be 5, 3. Matrix X is the variable matrix. And since our variables are x and y, we'll have one column, x and y. Matrix B is our constant matrix, and our constants are both 1. So we have 1 and 1. So our goal here is to solve this equation for matrix X. So next we'll find the inverse of matrix A and multiply both sides of the equation by the inverse matrix. Let's go ahead and find this inverse matrix on the next slide. Using the formula for a 2x2 inverse matrix, A inverse would be equal to 1 divided by 2 times 3, which is 6, minus 1 times 5, or minus 5, times a 2x2 matrix where we'll change the position of the 2 and the 3. So we'll have the 3 here and the 2 here, and we'll change the sign of the 1 and the 5. Well, 6 minus 5 is equal to 1. 1 divided by 1 is equal to 1. So our inverse matrix is just the 2x2 matrix where the first row is 3, negative 1, and the second row is negative 5, 2. So again, now we're going to multiply both sides of the equation by A inverse. So we'll have A inverse here and here. Once again, remember the order of this multiplication is important. So again, we have A inverse times matrix A times matrix X equals A inverse times matrix B. Well, we should recognize that A inverse times A is equal to a 2x2 identity matrix. The identity matrix times matrix X would just give us matrix X. So we have X, Y. And on the right side, we have A inverse times B. Notice A inverse is a 2x2 matrix, and matrix B is a 2x1 matrix. So because the number of columns in the first matrix, the number of rows in the second matrix are the same, the multiplication is defined, and the product will be a 2x1 matrix, which we have set up here. So to find the element in row 1, column 1, where a sub 1, comma 1, we're to multiply row 1 in the first matrix by column 1 of the second matrix. So we'd have 3 times 1, that's 3, plus negative 1 times 1, that's negative 1, so that's equal to positive 2. To find the element in row 2, column 1, a sub 2, comma 1, we'll now multiply row 2 in the first matrix by column 1 in the second matrix, which would be negative 5 times 1, that's negative 5, plus 2 times 1, that's 2, which is equal to negative 3. So our solution is x equals 2, y equals negative 3. Of course, if we want, we can check this on a graphing calculator. Let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to go ahead and enter matrix A and matrix B into the calculator. So I'm going to press second, matrix, right arrow to edit. Press enter. Matrix A is a 2x2 matrix, so I'll press 2, enter, 2, enter. Type in the elements. 2, enter, 1, enter, and so on. Now we'll enter in matrix B, so second, matrix, right arrow to edit, go down to matrix B, press enter, 2, enter, 1, enter, and then enter the elements, which are 1 and 1. So let's do two things. Let's first check our inverse matrix. So go back to the home screen, select matrix A, second matrix, select matrix A by pressing enter. Press x to the negative 1 for the inverse key and press enter. This verifies that our inverse matrix is correct. And for the last step, let's go and check our product, which gave us our solution, 2 comma negative 3. Because I've already entered A inverse, I'm going to press second enter, which brings back A inverse. I'm going to multiply this by matrix B. So times second matrix, matrix B, so I arrow down to number 2, press enter, and enter. Which, as we can see, does verify our solution, x equals 2, y equals negative 3. Okay, I hope you found this helpful. We'll take a look at a second example in the next video.